checking in with you because I know I've been offline for a bit. It's 12 o'clock here in the Netherlands, and my brand new single, Thousand Faces, just dropped. And just wherever you are in the world right now, around 12 o'clock, the single will drop. I'm so proud of this record. Donzo, yes. That's actually what my close friends call me and my father. So actually only my father and two really close friends. So, oh, you can't see. You can see me, right? Yeah, okay. So yeah, if you haven't heard it yet, if it's 12 o'clock, if you're in Europe, you can hear the new single now. Yeah, I wrote the song for my father while I was in Los Angeles a few months ago, and it seems like more relevant than ever now, because you know, I've been really reflecting on all of everything that's happened in the last couple of years. It feels like everything's going full circle now, so yeah, I'm really, really happy to share it with you guys finally. Shout out King Arthur, by the way. So let me see if I can answer some questions, if there are any. Let's see. Greetings from the Maldives. So when am I going back on tour? So I just announced a show that's gonna happen Saturday next week in Germany, in the Lanxess Arena in Cologne, together with the people from Boat's House. And this is gonna be the only Corona-proof arena. Tickets are super limited, so if you want to come by, it's gonna be super, super unique experience, I should say, a once in a lifetime. Because it's gonna be like special pods that you're going to be in, and you can be in with your friends. And yeah, I mean, just take my stories when I go offline. I'm as scared as you guys are. I don't know what's gonna happen. You know, like, yeah. This is my first and only Corona show, so I hope to see you guys there. I'm gonna play some new tunes as well there that I've been making in this quarantine, just so you guys know. Let me see if some more questions quickly. I see one. How is the feeling? How is the feeling for me to not be on stage that much? It's weird, guys. It's weird. I miss all of you. Good luck with the graduation, Thule. It's weird, but you know, I also, yeah, I have mixed emotions, so I don't know what to say. Sometimes I really miss it, and sometimes I think like Saturday next week might be my last show ever. I might not come back, but these thoughts are going back and forth, so I'm just being really honest. So, but yeah, I'm being very creative. There's a lot of cool stuff happening, just so you guys know. But yeah, it's a bit of both. I miss it, and I want to come back. I miss traveling, and I miss you guys mostly. Let's see. A lot of questions about my tattoos always. How many tattoos do I have? I don't know. I haven't counted, but there are a few more, as you probably have seen during Corona. Yeah, there's like a bunch now. they all have a very specific meaning. This is actually the first keyboard I ever bought. This is a Juno, Alpha Juno, which I made my first record with, and this is my second keyboard that I ever bought. So this kind of brings me back to when I was 15, you know, and just releasing my first records. So yeah, I'll keep explaining step by step. They're all like, they're all very meaningful to me. How excited am I for Tomorrowland? Will you hear any new songs there? You might. Yeah, for sure. I'm very excited, obviously. And I'm excited for Saturday next week to be back on stage for one time. I am saying no to all of the other shows. I'm very sorry to those who want to see me perform, but I'm not really the guy that be performing in front of cars or super small VIP clubs where people have to pay 200 euros. So I'm gonna wait it out. I'm gonna work on music and gonna be creative. I'm working on a book, which is gonna be really cool. And I'm working on some really cool projects, so don't be afraid. It will be worth the wait. That's my new credo. What do you like? French fries? Yes, I love it, Morgan. Of course, who doesn't love French fries? You check out Morgan's release on Hexagon, by the way. French fries. I'm trying to eat healthy, but it's hard. It's quarantine, but yeah, I'm still trying to keep in shape. I'm doing my best. So, but obviously, we all love French fries. And I love mayonnaise as well. So I love the combination of mayonnaise and ketchup. Let's see. I might have to play on AMF this year. I think I was supposed to play. Yeah, but I don't think it's going to happen. So I think all shows are off for this year. So... And you know, I think there are some exceptions, like the show I'm going to do Saturday next week in Germany. But it's basically I'm going to play in a 40,000 capacity arena, but there will only fit like 1,200 people in there. So it's going to be special. It's going to be weird and special. So yeah, how is Sayonara Boy in person? He's super nice, super sweet. He's actually very shy as well, funnily enough. I guess much like myself. Top lessons during quarantine. No, I think I'm trying to learn about myself every day. I'm trying to learn different creative sides. I'm trying to learn different disciplines. I want to learn to play more instruments. I want to learn how to make more music. I want to be part of different projects. I want to not just engineer, but I also want to produce. I want to executive produce. The new music video for 1,000 Faces, I've 100% directed and produced myself. And it's special, you know. I'm really going back to being a 360 all around kind of artist, I guess. Can we make movies together after you're done with performing? Yes, Maddie, that is the goal. You never know. It might be the last show anytime. But yeah, I'm between two ferns right now. Like, it might be... I might do a massive tour when touring is coming back. I might do a massive bus tour through Europe and America. And South America, if possible. But the drive is too far. But so I'm going to have to fly that. But yeah... You never know. Many questions, no answers. Hello, Alicita. When your digital world will implode? I'm not sure what that question means, but there is something really special in the works that I am more excited about than ever, so... But you never know with me. It's because it might take long. Because I live in the future. Let's see. What do you think about the Tomorrowland event online? I mean, I'm working. I've been speaking to the creative directors, and it's gonna be special. It's gonna be worth the wait, the money. Because I see some people are saying that they want tickets for free, but I think if you see how much love and time and energy these guys are putting into it, it's a massive team, and they're putting in lots of effort and time. So it's very stressful. They're really, really working their balls out of their pants to make something really cool for us. So let's see. Um, what was it like working with Jessie J? She's actually really sweet. Yeah, really caring, sweet female. So yeah, that was really, really, really nice actually. She's never actually featured on a record from someone else, so that was special. Have you ever got bullied in your life? 100%, yeah. I was a, you know. Big kid growing up, that was a bit of a weirdo, you know, with a ponytail, always wearing the long black jacket with the army boots, no friends, always focused on creation. But yeah, I always say that the line between madness or you know, pure craziness and genius is a very thin line. That's line is called success. So I think most of my life people thought I was an idiot. I think a lot of people still do, but I think once you cross the line of what people perceive to be success, all of a sudden you go into a whole different bracket. But I think for those of you who don't have what is, you know, seemingly perceived as success by the rest of the world, that doesn't mean that you're not incredibly talented or smart or successful. Yeah, that's the one thing I've learned that we need to move away from. We need to move away from the amounts of likes we get, from the record sales we have, the money we earn with our job, etc., etc. So, I mean, even with, you know, I wanted to do this very personal, you know, sort of campaign on my socials the last 2 weeks. And I know these videos are not as like sexy or as shareable as, you know, some of my TikTok stuff. But this is something that's honest. It comes from my heart. And I want to thank you guys for the reactions. Yeah, it was really something that, you know, was as me as it could get. It really came from the heart. So thank you for your amazing reactions. Greetings to Spain and Mexico, by the way. It's not about how much money you make, but how many lives you can touch. That's exactly what it is. I was talking about it while I'm writing this book. It's like, you know, when are you really... Someone asked me, are you rich? I'm like, I don't know. I don't even know the definition of rich. I know people are wealthy, some people are rich, but I think... I actually haven't looked in my bank account for over 8 years. So actually I have no idea, because I don't want to know anything about money. I don't want to be driven by money or... you know, make decisions based on money. I need to create, and I want to keep surprising you guys. So, yeah, it's a little bit weird, I know. But yeah, I always ask my business manager, can I afford this phone sleeve? Yes? Okay, then I will buy it. Amazing. He said, you know, you can actually afford 4 of those. I was like, that's amazing. I only need 1. So just... seek what you need. Thou shalt not need more. Let's see. There's a lot of questions. Things are popping up out here. You have not thought of helping producers who start you in the world of music. That's basically what I've been dedicated my life to for the last 5 years. It's a platform called Hexagon. It's a label. It's a radio show. It's a platform for producers, mostly unknown producers, to you know, to get discovered, and I guide them through the world of music. So if you don't know what it is, go check it out. It's called Hexagon. Jesse Mahasla. Yeah, you always have to be patient, you know. You can never assume. I hate it when I meet someone who's like super famous and they don't shake my hand and they don't tell me their name. You know, it's always about being humble. You should never assume that people know everything about you or know who you are. Even if you're the most popular kid in the class, guys, always stay humble. Always introduce yourself like this is the first time you're seeing a person. So let's see, let's do another question. By the way, I got a haircut, guys. Check it out. Hey, let me know what you think. It's shorter on the sides. It's a little bit of a hooligan look here, but let's see. Here we go. What genre you? What genre me? Me genre future. Let's see. Thank you, by the way, for the compliments on the hair. Appreciate it. And also, yeah, with genres, I'm working on some stuff that, I mean, it's kind of futuristic. Even in Thousand Faces, the new single that came out today, unless you're not in Europe or in Asia, it's coming out 12 o'clock your time, my brand new single, Thousand Faces. Even that has like small elements of you know, futuristic elements in there. But I really weighed in on the emotion there. But even with the drop, I try to make it a bit wonky. You can hear like in the piano, I guess. Music video is very special as well, guys. It drops on Sunday on Father's Day. Unless you are German, then Father's Day was last week. Let's see. Let's see. Boom. Oh, there's a lot of good questions, guys. This is tough. But I'm going to start with this one. Happy birthday, Daniel. And I'm going to go to the next one. Sven is asking me, don't you need sleep? No, I definitely need sleep. And maybe a little bit less sleep than certain other people. But yeah, I mean, usually I sleep like 4 hours a day for sure, so I definitely sleep. So, but sometimes I skip a night. So, but then I have bags under my eyes. As you can see, today is pretty good. And don't screenshot that; I will kill you. No, just kidding. What's my most used synth? It's always going to be Serum at the moment, and actually Omnisphere as well, for just vibes. Where do you get such nice, cool sounds? It's layering. It's all stacking and taking all the elements I find interesting in a certain sound. But it's never just one sound just came out of the straight out of that synth. It's always layers and layers and layers. Someone said about Indonesian. Yes, my mother's Indonesian. So, well, my mother's half Indonesian. Was born in Jakarta, but I am I'm a quarter Indonesian, hence the fact that I'm not blonde like typical Dutchman. Grap het zeg laat ou. I know, man. Let's see, let's do some questions. Let's see. Let's get it. You're almost. What are your tips to become a famous DJ? I don't actually know, to be honest. I think everybody's going to give the standard answer. You got to work hard. You got to believe in your dreams. You got to keep going, no matter what people say. You got to have your own style. You gotta be unique, you gotta be you. But I've come to the conclusion that you just gotta fucking do it. Honestly, one thing I know about life is it is going to disappoint you. It's not fair, but it's really in down to like how hard you're willing to work and how humble you are. Like, boom, work for free. Boom, keep working and keep training, boom, you know. Even with DJing, I'm still practicing. I still work on the craft of DJing, you know. Like, I know a lot of people don't care about transitions anymore, but I think that's still, it's still a true art to be a good DJ. I think, you know, just care about something. And in the meanwhile, just do other stuff. Like, it's not really, you can all be a successful DJ at home or whatever. But I think we all have the dream to perform in front of a shitload of people and make a shitload of money and then fly around the world. But I think it all starts with making music and wanting to be an artist. I don't think you should want to be a DJ. I think the DJing comes after. That's a nice bonus. I never wanted to be a DJ, so I never even wanted to be a musician. So only thing I wanted to be was a good son. So here I am. My favorite hip-hop artist, Sonny. It's a good question. I really love Kendrick Lamar. But I also, he's not really hip-hop, but I also do like Frank Ocean. And who else do I like? There's so many. But I think, yeah, they're definitely in my top two. I honestly really love a lot of the Kanye stuff as well. And Lange Frans. Come on, toppie met de floppy. See, that's my Lange Frans impression for Jesse. Let's see. Playboi Carti, yeah. To be honest, like, a lot of these rappers are, they don't have any, they're a lot of words, but they're not really saying anything. When it comes to that, someone like Missy Elliott, you know, I really love what she did, because Missy, she's not really saying anything, but her flow is just incredible. And she's also like, she's also like really, like, the beats are sick. So, and she produces as well. So Missy Elliott from old school. And if we go even back even further, it's going to be like NWA, Public Enemy, Osta Posse for the Dutch people. Extinct. I made a track with Extinct, a very famous Dutch rapper back in the days. Someone's asking, what would you say to your dad if you had the chance to speak with him right now? So I kind of did that on my last 6 posts on my Instagram. You know, I just wanted to, these are a couple of things that I wanted to tell him. It was kind of therapeutic finally talking to my dad again after all these years. I made a song for my dad, you know, almost 8 years ago when he passed away. But that song I made in a week, and I felt like, you know, it's a whole different story now, so many years later, because I never really had big success when my dad was still alive. So much has happened since he passed away. Actually, that gave me the fuel to be where I am right now, because I stopped giving a shit, and I started waving away criticism. So I think, you know, that really was part of my success, and I owe it to my dad. So if anything, I would like to thank him, like I did on my last video on my Instagram. What advice have you got for people? Elliot, I will advise you to always say whatever the hell you're thinking. There's no need to lie, because the truth always works best.